Welcome back everybody to Keening KTV. In this video, I want to talk about the Kelvin Gastelum vs Israel Adesanya fight, but mainly focus on why Kelvin Gastelum would defeat Israel the Last Stylebender Adesanya. I have made part 1 to this episode right here, where I talked about Israel Adesanya defeating Kelvin Gastelum. You guys can check that episode out with the link in the description. Also, a lot of people have been asking me about the songs that I use in my videos. You guys can simply join the Discord with the link in the description, and you can find all of my songs that I use in my videos. So with that being said, let's jump right into the video. Immediately, what I would like to talk about is Kelvin Gastelum's height. Obviously, in the first episode, I talked about why that would be a disadvantage going up against Israel Adesanya. But I believe it is time for me to talk about why that would be an advantage in this fight. Obviously, Israel Adesanya is a pretty calculated, pretty smart striker. He likes to stay on the outside, pick his opponents apart piece by piece, and just break them down as the fight goes on. One thing that he doesn't really have is that one-hit KO power. And Kelvin Gastelum being himself, he already has a granite chin, as it showed against Jacare Souza, Tyron Woodley. He is definitely a guy with a chin on him. So for me to think that, okay, Israel Adesanya, for him to go in there and knock him out, that is something that I've already scratched off the table. Now, why that is relevant to his height, because this fight is probably going to be a 5-rounder fight. Obviously, for Kelvin Gastelum to get in on Israel Adesanya, he has to close the distance. Now, luckily for him, that is something that he does his entire career. He has always been the smaller guy. He always had to duck under the jab. He always had to close the distance quickly, get in on the inside, make it a gnarly fight, throw quick short combinations on the inside. That is where Israel Adesanya doesn't like to be, and that is where Kelvin Gastelum is as strong as that. Now, in that range, we have to understand that Israel Adesanya has big size advantage. I mean, the guy is about, what, 5 inches, 6 inches taller than him, has a 8.5 reach advantage over Kelvin Gastelum. I mean, the size difference is huge. So for Kelvin Gastelum to get on the inside is going to be very, very hard, especially in the first opening 2 rounds. The thing is, that is not going to be a big of a concern for me. For Kelvin Gastelum to win this fight, he has to take a couple hits. I mean, this is not going to be a fight where he has all the advantages in terms of size, in terms of physical attributes, just overall. Maybe one advantage that he has is definitely the power, but other than that, I mean, the speed is on Israel Adesanya's side, reach, height, and those are things that you just cannot underestimate. Those are things that you just cannot overlook. But really, when a fight starts off and Israel Adesanya is just keeping Kelvin Gastelum at the end of his reach and just picking him apart, which is most likely going to be what will be happening. However, what will be saving Kelvin Gastelum is the fact that he can definitely take a couple hits. It is only a matter of time before Israel Adesanya is going to be showing enough of his offensive skills and his defensive skills. He's probably going to be on the outside in the majority of the fight. I truly doubt that he is going to be coming forward and taking the center of the octagon over Kelvin Gastelum, because by nature, Kelvin always comes forward, and by nature, Israel Adesanya just likes to keep his distance. In the first opening couple of rounds, 1, 2, maybe even 3, I think that Kelvin Gastelum is going to be kept at the end of Israel Adesanya's reach, at the end of his distance. It is going to become very hard for Kelvin Gastelum to find his rhythm. However, with his toughness, and he's lucky that this fight is a 5-rounder, comes the ability to be collecting data. The more data that he collects, the more adjustments that he can make. We have to understand that Israel Adesanya is probably going to be fighting one way. He wants to avoid getting taken down by Kelvin Gastelum, and he wants to be avoiding this fight of becoming a dogfight. He wants to keep it at a certain distance where he can pick him apart and be in control of the range. Now, to do this, Israel Adesanya has his own tricks, has his own defensive maneuvers. For example, when he gets pressured and he has his back close against the cage, he likes to just sidestep away, duck his head, cut a quick angle, and exit out. Those certain strategies may be able to work in the first couple of rounds where Kelvin Gastelum doesn't really know how Israel Adesanya moves. And that is the big advantage that I believe Kelvin Gastelum has that a lot of people are overlooking. The fact that he can have Israel Adesanya display all of his tricks, all of his skills early on in the fight. Because later down the fight, I highly doubt that Israel Adesanya will be showing anything new from what he had shown in the first round. Israel Adesanya can post up on Kelvin Gastelum. He can move away, he can circle away, he can do his signature head movement to get in and out for only so long before it becomes repetitive, and until Kelvin Gastelum catches on to what Israel Adesanya is doing. And once he has caught on to Israel Adesanya's rhythm and way of fighting in this fight, that is going to become the turning point. Because the longer the fight goes on, the more that Calvin Gastelum will get picked apart. Yes, that is most likely going to be happening. But luckily for him, as I said, that chin of his is just something that he can always depend on. He's probably one of the more strongest guys when it comes to chin and being able to take a hit or two and still come forward. And that is a style that is typically bad against somebody who is always trying to be on the outside. If you cannot demand the respect, if you cannot get the respect that you need in order for your opponent to actually calm down and like give you the distance, then you have basically lost your way of fighting in that fight. And if Calvin Gastelum can get the fight to that point, then the tables will be starting to turn, because that will mean that Calvin Gastelum will be finally finding his way through that long reach of Israel Adesanya, that long distance. Once he can find a rhythm that is consistently letting him in on the outside, that is where he can land his shots and get himself in the fight. Now from there, he can do what he always does, his signature hook straight, or maybe even shooting for a takedown, which is probably the best thing that he can do in this fight. Because looking at Israel Adesanya, that size advantage, that reach is going to be just a huge nightmare for him to deal with. And if he can get him to the floor, that is going to be one area in the fight where Calvin Gastelum just completely outdoes Israel Adesanya. Israel Adesanya is a terrific striker, one of the best in the division. But when it comes to the grappling department, he's still unproven. Whereas Calvin Gastelum, he has proven his worth when it comes to the grappling department. For example, taking down Uriah Hall in the Ultimate Fighter finale, in a fight where he was clearly not the better striker, he was able to just get in on the inside, take the fight to the ground, and just wear his opponent down from there and win the rounds and win the fight. But let's just say the fight gets stood up again. The memory that probably Israel Adesanya will be having from being taken down is not going to be a good memory, and that is going to be affecting him and the way he fights in the stand-up department. Because if we continue on using the theory of Calvin Gastelum getting the range, getting the rhythm on Israel Adesanya in the 4th and 5th round, by that point, we have to assume that Calvin Gastelum will be doing everything in his power to be able to get the fight back onto the floor, and really, Israel Adesanya shouldn't really have a lot of options of defending Calvin Gastelum by that point. So what I'm trying to say is this, by using that logic, we would have to assume that Calvin Gastelum will become more consistent in getting the fight to the grappling department, taking the fighter down, and dominating him from there. Because up to this point, Israel Adesanya hasn't really fought anybody of Calvin Gastelum's level of experience and just all around complete game. We can take a look at Derek Brunson and we can say, okay, Israel Adesanya was able to defend all of his takedowns. That shouldn't be a problem when it comes to Calvin Gastelum. Now that is something that I would have to disagree on, because Calvin Gastelum, when it comes to the grappling department and the stand-up department, those are two departments where he is comfortable in. When it comes to Derek Brunson, it looks like whenever he's striking, it is as if he's consistently in a takedown ready posture, like similarly to what Ben Askren like kind of fights in, like in that stance. So he completely didn't have any confidence in his striking abilities against Israel Adesanya, and he became a bit of a desperate wrestler, and that was really where Israel Adesanya was able to pick him apart. He won't have that against Calvin Gastelum. He will probably be able to pick Calvin Gastelum apart, but I highly doubt that Calvin Gastelum will become frustrated or even make mistakes to the point where he's just going to walk into a big knee like Derek Brunson did, for example, right? Another area where Calvin Gastelum outshines Israel Adesanya in is the experience factor. Experience is something that Calvin Gastelum definitely has over Israel Adesanya. Adesanya just fought Anderson Silva, who just came off of a layoff and he was about 42 years old, not his old self. Before that, he fought Derek Brunson, who's never really been the top contender over middleweight. Before that, you know, he obviously fought Brad Tavares, Marvin Vettori, Wilkinson, guys like that, okay? But that is not going to be preparing him for somebody of Calvin Gastelum's level. Calvin, he has seen a lot more things than Israel Adesanya in MMA that he can definitely use against him. If this was kickboxing, obviously Israel Adesanya is going to be completely just outdoing him, because that is just a realm that Calvin Gastelum has never been in. Now, because this is MMA and because Calvin Gastelum has fought former champions, I would have to say that the longer the fight goes on, the more that Calvin Gastelum will be getting a read on Israel Adesanya, and the more mistakes and the more patterns that Israel Adesanya will show that Calvin Gastelum should be able to pick up on. Now, definitely one thing that we cannot overlook is that size difference, and that is where the fight becomes more so an even playing field. Ultimately, only time will tell. For now, this has been why Calvin Gastelum defeats Israel the Last Stylebender Adesanya. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Leave who you guys think is going to be winning come fight night in the comment section down below. I will be leaving out my own prediction for the Ultimate Breakdown series that I do. So with that being said, I have been Keenan from Keenan KTV, signing off. Later.